JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for March the 18th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar fell against all the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It lost the most ground versus AUD, NZD and NOG in that order, while it underperformed the least against JPY and CHF. Now, the weakening of the US dollar, the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi, as well as the relative weakness of the safe havens yen and franc, suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, looking at the performance in the equity world, we see that although major EU indices traded mixed, the US and Asian ones were a sea of green, with the Dow Jones and the S&P 500 hitting fresh all-time highs. The main event on yesterday's agenda was the FOMC monetary policy decision. Policymakers decided to keep all their policy settings unchanged via unanimous vote, noting that bond purchases will continue until substantial further progress has been made towards their maximum employment and price stability goals. As far as the new dot plot is concerned, four members voted for hikes in 2022, while seven members saw rates higher in 2023. But the median dots suggested that the interest rates are likely to stay at present levels even in 2023. Even though officials upgraded their economic and inflation forecasts, inflation is seen at 2.4% this year. Fed Chair Powell clearly said that this will be temporary and would not meet their standards. He also stuck to his guns that it is too early to discuss tapering quantitative easing. Despite the optimism surrounding the economy, it seems that the Fed appeared more dovish than many may have expected, and thus the dollar fell and equities gained. It appears that some market participants may have been expecting to see more members voting for hikes in 2023, or at least get hints that tapering may be on the cards soon. In any case, the outcome is in line with our view, although we expected the dollar to react more moderately. Remember that we expected officials to stay dovish, as several of them noted that any spike in inflation is likely to prove to be temporary, while the minutes of the previous meeting clearly revealed that inflation is likely to rise and stay for some time above 2% in the years after 2023. With inflation fears easing further and expectations over a tighter monetary policy diminishing, we stick to our guns that the US currency is likely to continue to weaken and that equities and other risk-linked assets are likely to continue trending north. The safe havens, yen and franc, are likely to stay on the back foot. Today, the central bank torch will be passed to the Bank of England. At its latest gathering, this bank kept its policy unchanged and pushed back the idea of negative interest rates. The central bank said that British banks will need at least 6 months to prepare for a shift into negative interest rates, but that doesn't mean that the central bank is intended to set a negative rate at some point in the future. It was just concluded that it would be appropriate to start preparations in order to provide the capability to do so if necessary. Now, with Bank of England policymakers being aligned with the relaxed views of the Fed over the recent rally in bond yields around the globe, we believe that they have no immediate plans to counter the market reaction. Thus, taking into account that the COVID vaccinations proceed very well in the UK, we believe that this bank is likely to maintain a degree of optimism, which may allow the pound to perform well, especially against the US dollar and the safe havens yen and franc. Tonight, during the Asian morning, we have another central bank deciding on monetary policy, and this is the Bank of Japan. At their previous meeting, officials of this bank kept monetary policy unchanged and revised up their economic forecasts for the next fiscal year. However, they repeated that they will take additional steps without hesitation if deemed necessary. With this bank committed to keep its long-term government bond yields around zero, we don't expect any major reaction to the recent rally in other nations' yields. After all, this is something negative for the yen, which works in favor for the bank as it may help boost the nation's inflation. However, Nikkei reported that the bank will widen the band around the 10-year government bond yields to tolerate rises and falls of 0.25%. By allowing yields to fluctuate more, the Bank of Japan will help ease the strain ultra-low interest rates and a flattering yield curve inflict on financial institutions' profits, the Nikkei newspaper reported. The Japanese yen may strengthen somewhat if this is the case, but overall we expect it to continue to trend south. With inflation fears fading, market sentiment is likely to stay supported, which is negative for the safe haven yen. Now, as for the rest of today's events, besides the Bank of England monetary policy decision, we only get the US initial jobless claims for last week, and expectations are for a small slide to 700,000 from 712,000. During the Asian session Friday, apart from the Bank of Japan decision, we also have Japan's national CPIs for February. While no forecast is available for the headline rate, the core one is anticipated to have risen somewhat to minus 0.4% year over year from minus 0.6%. We also have two speakers on today's agenda, and those are ECB Vice President Luis de Guindos and ECB Executive Board Member Isabel Schnabel. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye. Have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.